journey soon begins.
Its prize reflected in another's eyes.
When what you see is what you lack,
then selfless love will change you back.
Whatever.
I have been so excited for this video for a hot ass minute. This week I'll be trading lives with none other than Sally Tim. Sally is a booktuber that I have stumbled across over the past year, and in my opinion, her booktube content is next fucking level. My personal favorite vlogs of hers are the ones that are centered around Gilmore Girls.
I know you better than anyone. This isn't you.
And it's because of her that I started my first watch of this show. I'm on season 3. She has this impeccable series going on right now where she reads throughout the decades. I think she's wonderful is the theme. This video is in collaboration with her. I'm going to be living her life for the week. She's going to be living my life for a week, and we're both going to be reading each other's favorite books. I'm so excited. But before we dive into that, let's hear it from today's sponsor.
Sally and I were lucky enough to have this collaboration sponsored by Ana Luisa, an online sustainable jewelry company whose mission statement is very clear, that high quality jewelry should not cost the planet. They are both 100% carbon and water neutral. Their diamonds are lab grown, meaning they're cruelty free. But personally, I'm excited to be working with them because I have bought from them before in the past with my own money, and I was happy with my experience, so I'm comfortable to recommend them to you. So without further ado, let's dive into the pieces that I chose. The first ones I got are these mini Hana hoop earrings. They're burgundy. They come in different colors as well. They fit my ears so nice, even though I've had stretch lobes in the past. They're a cute and simple piece, but with a pop of color. The next ones I got are these ones that I'm wearing right now. They are the Cuidado gold hoop earrings. These are just your classic gold hoop that catch the sun beautifully, but they have this really fun and funky elongated shape to them. I could wear these with any outfit. The next earrings I got helped me manifest the art teacher career of my dreams, and they are the Hana collage enamel hoop. It's definitely the most fun thing that I chose. The colorful abstract shapes. Just add a splash of spice to your day if you're feeling down, you know what I mean? And last but not least is the Stephanie ring that I'm wearing right now. I actually got this ring to replace my wedding band. When I got married almost 6 years ago, I was very, very sick. So on the downside, my wedding ring doesn't fit me anymore, but how lucky am I to be healthy again? This gold band is so much more suitable for me, seeing as it matches all my other jewelry and it's just timeless. And hey, maybe, probably, most likely, you're getting your ring for a less formal reason, which works because all of their rings are great for stacking with other pieces. The other ring here is called Nell, and it's the one that I purchased myself in the past. Right now they have a Mother's Day sale happening, so if you get one piece of jewelry, you can get one for 40% off. You can get two pieces for your mom, maybe one piece for your mom and one piece for yourself. I'm not here to judge you. So if you'd like, click the link in the description box below to take a gander at the many timeless pieces that they have to offer you. Thank you so much, Ana Luisa, for sponsoring this video. I feel so fancy. On with the video.
And we're back. Let's get on the phone with Sally and figure out what our week is gonna look like.
Hi, Allie!
Hi, Sally!
I feel like it's gonna be the best week of my life. Do you wanna know what your week looks like?
I'm taking notes.
And I have it written down so I can also send it to you.
Oh, okay.
First, my coffee routine. I drink at least one cup of black coffee in the morning. Mm-hmm. And then usually what I do is I let the pot sit, and then in the afternoon I have a cup of iced coffee.
How long do you have it sit in the pot?
It just sits there until I wanna drink it.
Yeah, so you like diarrhea. Number one, diarrhea.
Yes. Yeah. Number one, shit yourself. Yeah. My favorite thing.
Okay.
And then I have a nature walk.
Oh, okay.
Third is FaceTime a friend who lives far away.
Oh, I love that.
Number four is you gotta blast music and have a dance party.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Absolutely.
Do this all the time. I recommend either I listen to a whole album top to bottom, which I also often do on my nature walks, or a playlist that I have that I'll send you.
Get a playlist
for the challenges. There's a couple that might conflict with what you normally do.
Okay.
One, write a letter to a friend.
Yeah.
This one, my family and I sit down and watch a childhood favorite movie together. Perfect.
I just got all these Disney movies in Het Nederland.
Oh my gosh, perfect.
Yay.
Get some popcorn, make it a little moment.
How is this a challenge?
Well, now we're gonna get to the ones that are challenging.
Okay.
This is X Games mode because it would involve plans after 5 p.m. That is. But if it's this or have a panic attack, don't have a panic attack.
Okay.
I love to go to like pub quizzes.
Ooh.
Like trivia nights.
Yeah.
I don't know what the sitch is. I also don't know if they'll be in English.
True. Maybe I can host my own trivia night. Like I can have my friends make a Kahoot or something.
That's genius.
That's fine.
And then the last one, a challenge called Escape Roll.
Oh, Savannah Brown's Escape Roll. test?
Yes.
I tried last year and I hated everything I wrote. It stressed me out.
Write a poem for Escape Role, but before that, in parentheses, I have try to. If I do it without the intention of ever, like, sharing it or wanting it to be good, a lot of times it helps me, like, process stuff that's been, like, mucked up in my head. Doesn't have to be good. I still sat down and wrote and, like, paid attention to some stuff I needed to pay attention to.
That's so therapeutic and healthy and good.
It's gonna be so cute.
I'm so excited.
Maybe we should tell each other a little bit about why we chose the books that we chose.
Smart. Break. Disclaimer, we did tell each other which books we are picking because we needed to have books. Don't look.
The books I chose for you are The Little Prince or La Petite Prince.
Der kleine Prinz.
Der kleine Prinz by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. This has been a favorite book of mine since the sixth grade. It has amazing illustrations, but also it's about holding on to the inner child and like celebrating the child in you even when you're grown up and like the things we lose when we become adults and how we don't have to lose them. It like unlocked something new in me, like something that I hadn't known I had in, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like so magical and fantastical and fun and sweet.
I think I'm gonna get the English version because I'm a little overwhelmed by this.
And then the other one I've chosen for a few reasons. It's Slaughterhouse-Five by Kurt Vonnegut. For one thing, one of my favorite books of all time, a very different narrative style than I've ever seen before. This idea that hope doesn't have to be something that we like can definitively see or even something that we necessarily deserve, like as a human race. One other reason that I chose it is because it's one of Jess Mariano's favorite books.
This video is canceled. Jess is a fart of a man.
I think it makes a lot of sense that it's one of Jess's favorites.
Is Kurt Vonnegut a magician too?
What are you doing?
Ooh, no.
All this?
No.
Nothing.
Good morning. Cheers. Baby's first cup of coffee. Can she drink two a day? We shall see. This morning, I'm doing some invoicing, doing some emails, and I'm also watching Kirstie's new video. I love spending my Monday morning with my coffee and my Kirstie. It's like a little ritual whenever she uploads. Happy Mondays for me. Then I'm gonna dive into Slaughterhouse-Five. She's really short, but she is a classic, so I might struggle to get through it. However, technically had this book on my TBR since I was in high school. There's obviously a reason I'm putting it off. I'm going to be reading this one first, so then I'm guaranteed to end on a high. I know I'm gonna love The Little Prince. Will it be a new favorite? I think so. They didn't have any English ones at the store, so I did order The Little Prince online. It's really pretty. It should be here today. I'm very excited. For now, let's have a morning. One step at a time. All right, so I spent a few hours working this morning, and it's editing, and it's me and all that jazz. I was just about to dive into Slaughterhouse-Five, but the mail's here.
You'll dance with me.
Let's go!
Here's the mail, it never fails. It makes me wanna wag my tail. When it comes, I wanna wail.
The cat's medicated food is also here. We're very excited about it.
Woohoo! Look at how beautiful she is. Look at the little planets. It's so cute. Ah,
I want to read it so bad, but I have to read the other one first. It came with a little card. You can only see things clearly with your heart. What is essential is invisible to the eye. Oh, I'm gonna love this book so much. I just know it.
There's planets on the
Remain calm. So yeah, let's take some time to dive into Slaughterhouse-Five first. We have to earn our way to this one. They match. How nice.
Okay, let's do it.
What he meant, of course, was that there would always be wars and that they were as easy to stop as glaciers. I believe that too.
Nobody tell Kurt Vonnegut about global warming.
I know this book is anti-war, but I'm prepared to commit a war crime on my bowels!
That's right. It's been about 4 hours since my last cup of coffee. According to the life of Sally, I have to have another one. However, I have IBS. Fun fact, so if I put another black coffee in my stomach, I will cease to exist. We're gonna put oat milk in the second one. I have to. I'm sorry. Jar.
This is gonna look weird, but the only ice cubes we have are these reusable ones.
And last but not least, our coffee that's been fermenting on our counter for 4 hours.
Give her a stir, give her a straw.
Coffee just tastes so much dirtier when it sits out. Oat milk makes it nice.
Now it's a treat.
I'm breaking the rules! We've got my peanut butter cookie and jelly baked oats. And enough caffeine to awaken a corpse. I read the first two chapters of Slaughterhouse 5, so essentially the first third-ish. First impressions is that this very much reads like a classic. When I read a book, a movie plays in my head, but this is not really a linear story. The settings aren't ever really described. It's just a lot of objective facts, almost like a list. But there are a lot of poetic moments. I already have some underlines and some dog ears in here, so I don't think I'm gonna hate it.
Honey, you've got a big storm coming.
Drink iced coffee, panic attack. Drink iced coffee, panic attack.
Yesterday being Sally didn't really go as planned. I drank my second coffee and everything fell apart. My body was simply not used to that much caffeine. I went for my walk but couldn't enjoy it because everything was just going too fast. I finished Slaughterhouse 5 and then tried to compile my feelings for it. My heart is palpitating and in pain. I'm not smart enough for her. I'm simply not. She's done. I'm sorry. My brain, mashed potatoes. I am simply not here. My spirit is elsewhere. I'm on autopilot mode. I might get a migraine.
Shut up. Just shut up.
Anyway, this book very much felt like anything I was assigned to read in high school. You know, where you read 20 pages and then go, did I read 20 pages? Could I tell you what just happened? No. What did I just read? Exactly. I struggle with classics because I'm not smart enough. Sally's a hot girl, smart girl, reads poetry, reads classics, truly a walking, living, breathing Roy Gilmore. Meanwhile, I'm Kirk and I'm keeping it real.
It's good.
And I did not like this. I'm so sorry. There were some quotes that I enjoyed, particularly page 83, which states, she upset Billy simply by being his mother. She made him feel embarrassed and ungrateful and weak because she had gone to so much trouble to give him life and to keep that life going. And Billy didn't really like life at all. If I were in high school when I read this, I would have clung to those depressive quotes like my life depended on it, disregard how little this book made sense to me, to maintain my artificial sense of elitism that I created for myself, and been like, I love this book. I love Vonnegut. But I'm 27. I have nothing to prove anymore. And I did not have a good time reading this one. I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to spark notes it. I read it. There are dog ears, there are underlines. What happened? However, this is the kind of book that I don't think less of you if you like it. I more so applaud you and I'm in awe of you and I wish I were you because you liked it because I am simply not, you know? Anyway, did it. I'm gonna get a migraine.
That always puts the fear of God in me.
Fuck. And then I had to sit in bed from like 2 p.m. onwards. I did reach out to two friends to see if we could talk on the phone, just didn't get an answer. So yesterday was a bust. I had a little bit of a migraine hangover. So not too much is gonna happen today. I did go for a walk. Lawrence and I had to walk all over the place to try and get footage of the cowboy cat merch. So that was fun. Just still recovering from yesterday. That's about it. It's Wednesday. I've gone for my hot girl walk every single day since Monday. Three down, two to go. I did get permission from Sally to not have two coffees a day. Thank you so much. Where we have fallen short is FaceTiming friends. I reached out to some people on Monday and haven't heard back from any of them. I'm not a very social creature, if the fact that I read 103 books last year didn't already tell you that. But I did sit outside in the park with a friend yesterday. Does that count for something? I hope so. I'm not doing as bad as I thought, aside from the fact that we borderline hated one of Sally's favorite books. I haven't gotten any reading done today, which is probably why I feel so weird. It's been another one of those 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. working days. Hey!
What will you learn that your actions have consequences?
But it's fine. But seeing as that's the current state of affairs, I think we need to have a dance party. Because you know, with the whole Monday migraine situation, I had to recover and blah, blah, blah. So we're just gonna have a super intense dance party now to make up for lost time. And that's math. Let's do it.
Changed my
my destiny. And me and my boys went out just to end up in misery. Was about to go home when she was standing in front of me. I said, hi, I got a little place nearby. I wanna go. I should have said no. Someone's waiting for me. When I come, I go up and say, listen, baby, I'm sorry. Just wanna tell you, don't worry. I will be late, don't stay up and wait for me. I say again, you're dropping out. My battery is low. Just so you know, we're going to a place nearby.
What would you think if I sang out of tune?
Would you stand up and walk out on me?
Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song.
And I'll try not to sing out of key.
I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. Ooh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away?
Does it worry you to be alone?
How do I feel by the end of the day?
Are you sad because you're on your own?
I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. Ooh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends.
What's this? BDS meow?
No!
Three-way coffee.
Listen to your heart.
No!
We all guessed from cocky.
Hello, good morning. Thought we could do a little end of the week check-in. Cozy, comfy, nice.
Roomie's in a mood.
Look at it. Turned 3 yesterday and thinks he owns the place. If I had to grade myself on just how Sally I was this week, I would probably get a C+. I did go for my walk every single day though, and I think that is the most important one. I also watched a lot more Gilmore Girls this week than I usually do. I shared on my story that I'm Team Dean on Instagram, and people came for my throat. First of all, it's a TV show from like 20 years ago. Second of all, they're teenagers. I don't feel that passionately about it. But if we're gonna... I'm only on season 3, so maybe Dean becomes more of an issue later. To me, his jealousy seemed more normal. When I was a teenager, I didn't want my person kissing somebody else, even if it was for a play. Meanwhile, Jess is like, someone in town said you made eye contact with Dean. What the fuck? You gotta tell me these things, even though I don't talk to you ever. If you are Team Jess for any other reason aside from the fact that he's a hunk, I don't want to hear it. I wrote a poem, but I'm not sharing it. Thank goodness. I wrote a letter to a friend, but I'm not gonna share it. Trivia night happened. How cute was that? Reading. Let's check in on reading. As you already know, I struggled with Slaughterhouse-Five. It's not my thing. It's not my cup of tea. But we have to go to the favorite shelf to get the other one. I loved The Little Prince. I loved it. A lot of the books on my favorite shelf that are geared towards children are typically covering really dark and sad themes. And this one was very much just, adults sure are silly, aren't they? Making up their silly little problems and doing their silly little tasks. Stop and smell the roses. Quite literally. I loved the drawings. I loved the cover. I just loved this through and through.
This book deserves more screen time. The little prince comes back from Earth and he says where you come from. People grow 5,000 roses in one garden and still they do not find what they are looking for. What a good reminder. Focus on the now. Focus on what you have. Enjoy the present. Thank you, little prince. The fox is definitely a top tier favorite.
In a subtle way of telling us that our relationships are so fundamental to who we are and what makes us special.
Sorry. The little prince bounces between all these adults and all their mundane complications. This guy's doing some math. He says, it means I write down the numbers of stars I own on a piece of paper, and then I lock this paper up in a drawer. And that is all? That is enough. It is amusing, thought the little prince. It is even rather poetic. But it's not terribly serious. It's not terribly serious. Tattoo that on my forehead. I loved this. I need to read it every month. I love it so much. It was so cute. I love it so much. It will stay here in my heart. Forever and ever. I'll be so happy loving you. That's all.
I'm so intrigued to see how Sally's week went. We haven't checked in too much. This week flew by. She read Lonely Castle in the Mirror and Crying in HMR, which are two of my favorite books. Her video is up now. Friendly reminder that there are a couple weeks left to pre-order the Cowboy Cats merch. Baby's first design. It's been quite the week. I'm gonna go tackle this weekend ahead of me. It's gonna be a little bit nuts. Sally, thank you so much for such a fun week. Cheers. And an extra special thank you to Ana Luisa for sponsoring our collaboration. The link's at the top of the description box below. And as always, thank you for clicking, thank you for caring, and thank you for being nice. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!